So hey, welcome to my channel, and today I would want to just ramble about a piece that I just did a couple of days ago, and that I actually got to film. And it's a special piece for me simply because it's one of the first times I actually did it this way, because I did two previous pieces the same way, and I just want to talk about how I did it because I feel like it's a very useful and very nice technique to do something, especially for people who are just starting with digital and don't really know where to start. So what I did was I did the sketches and the line work, and I added some watercolor on the piece of paper. So traditionally, well, I personally find it easier to work traditionally at the very start, but then I feel like it's very flat and very boring because I don't have the patience to stay and finish the watercolor, for example, or gouache. I do it sometimes, but that's just rarely. However, I do really like digital because it allows you to experiment and add on a lot of different things, and you can change colors very easily, you can fix mistakes easily, you can do anything you want in digital, and that's why I like it. So what I did was I made the piece traditionally, and I scanned it in with just any printer or scanner. You can even photograph it, but I think that's not very good because sometimes watercolor gives you streaks, or like the paper just starts to like mount up, or I don't know. Scanner is always a good thing to do. Then you open a Photoshop, you open the file, you set the file the way you want it to be, and then you place the photograph, you start drawing on top of it. So you don't start drawing straight on top of it because that's going to ruin it, and you don't really want to do that because it's going to give you some texture and you can still play with it. And you just make different layers on top of the previous set background that gives you some direction of where you want to go. For people who are just starting, it's a very good practice, and it gives you a lot of control over what you want to, because you technically already have a set picture. You already know where everything is, you just need to finish off some details. So like, if the corals aren't bright enough, you just go on Photoshop and just draw them in. Of course, if you just do like a few things on top of the original painting, it'd be like, oh yeah, I forgot this, so I'm gonna add it into it, then it can look not as authentic or as nice on when drawn on Photoshop. But if you do the whole piece, so you add a few things here, you add a few effects, you add something else, you like redraw a character on it, then it's gonna be okay. It's gonna look good and it's gonna look complete. This is exactly what I did here and with like my few previous drawings, and I extremely liked it because I tend to freeze when it comes to traditional and digital media. So with traditional media, I tend to go and get bored very easily because I'd be like, oh yeah, why bother if I have like a setting on or a texture like this on Photoshop, which I can just press a button and it's just gonna do me this texture digitally. And manually, I would have to like redraw it every single time. So like with the polka dots or like, I don't know, small dashes, it would be like, yeah, it's just, I don't know, I find traditional media very, very tiring, and I don't have the, and I can't sit for too long and do it. But with digital, it's very easy because I don't know, I find it more easier than traditional because you can overlay something, you can change the colors, you can add any effect that you want. You can sometimes, although sometimes it doesn't really work because you're like, yeah, I want this effect, but it doesn't work, so what am I doing? But it's just a matter of playing with the colors, with the techniques, with the settings, and it can make actually a very good piece. So for example, like with a girl, I want it to glow, I want it to have the same aesthetic and to the other two figures that I did before. One of them was iridescent, the other one was fire. I need to redo the fire. But anyway, and I wanted this to be like coral themed because she wants to go to the other side, to the like marine life. And What is good with Photoshop is that you can actually source the colors that you want. So I found some glowing and iridescent corals and photographs, and I really like the color combination, so I like placed it over and color picked the colors and then did the figure. And what is really good with it is that I wanted it to glow, and in traditional media you need like mad skills to actually make it glow and think it ahead and advance, and sometimes I don't do that. So sometimes I can be like very spontaneous and be like, oh yeah, I want this and I want that, and I want like 1,000 different other things. And with Photoshop you can easily do that very quickly. So you just need to select the right setting for the layer. You need to just do the right color that you want. It can be pink, blue, I have orangey, yellow color, and it's just gonna overlay on top of the set picture and sometimes lighten it up if that's the setting that you choose. Same goes for darkening, so because I don't know, I love contrast between dark and light. So you just need to like do overlay and do like like you can either draw over it or place like a solid color or anything on top of it, and it's just gonna do you the effect that you want to do. And I think for people who want to get the art to a next level or to try something else, try something different, it's a very good technique and a very good way to actually start and get yourself into the digital art without pushing yourself over the limit, because you can practice and try endless different things and still get some sort of like a nice result. It's Photoshop, guys, everything's possible. So this is the final product, the one that I got, and as the last thing I would want to say is thank you for watching, and this is my first video ever actually made this kind of way. Thank you, and I will obviously try to get better, and I'm sorry for any inconveniences, and this is totally and completely my opinion and my experience of the things that I have and I did, and thank you.